Are you struggling to unlock full automation inside of your Airtable database? Well, if so, this video is for you because I am walking through how to do exactly this, not natively inside of the Airtable interface and the Airtable software itself, but instead we're going to go outside of that environment and use a third-party tool called Make. So if that's of interest, stick around and let's get into it. Welcome back to the channel. If you're new here, my name is Gareth. I am the owner here at Gap Consulting, where we help you organize and automate with no-code tools so that you can streamline your business and save up to 20 hours per week. Now, if that sounds impossible, it's probably because you're not familiar with how to leverage the power of no-code automation. And you're in luck because that's exactly what this video is going to be focusing on, how to build automated processes in a third-party tool called Make that we're going to integrate nicely with our no-code database in Airtable. But without further ado, let's jump into the heart of this video. We're talking about how we can leverage this no-code technology, specifically with Make. Now, in case you're not aware, Make was previously branded as Integromat. They recently went through a rebranding structure where they have added some additional features and bonuses to what they previously did as Integromat, and they are now under the name Make. So check them out. If you're not already signed up for Make, I have an affiliate link below that will get you 30 free days on your Make plan with up to 10,000 automated operations under that 30 days. So if you're brand new to this and you want to start for free without having to pay upfront, check out that link below. But what we're imagining here is the overall process that we want to automate. And this is a real life example and perhaps one of the most common examples that I see inside of automation with Airtable. In fact, I even run this very same process in my operations at Gap Consulting. So here I am in our website with three different options that we have for consulting. Yes, we have some hourly support or hourly consulting. We also sell courses, but for this particular one, we have custom development. And the first step in custom development in this specific process, we want to have an application filled out from our prospective clients. But before we go too far down that rabbit hole, we want to make sure that we have a good fit. So if someone were to select that they wanted to work with us on some custom development, they would make the selection and they can start filling out an application right here in our website. There are a number of questions here, and you'll notice that this is purposefully not an Airtable form. If you're an avid Airtable user, you'll know that Airtable has forms already pre-baked into the Airtable software, and those forms are really good, with the exception that they only have one function. That function is when somebody fills out that form, it's going to automatically add a record in one table. But if you were to go through this form, you'll find out that some of the questions we're asking are belonging to different data sets. Specifically, we have contact information. Who are you? What company are you representing? What's your email? And then we have application specific questions. What are you looking for in this project? What is your budget for this project? It's important to delineate between the contact information and the application for this specific project. And the reason is, over time, somebody may fill out this application multiple times. We wouldn't want to create a new contact for that person in every instance. So it's just one contact that could fill out the application numerous times that could produce different outputs from the application side of things. And that's exactly why we need a more robust form software. In this case, I use JotForm. And we need to automate the data collection from that form and plug it into our Airtable database, which is exactly what we're going to leverage Make for in our example. So flipping into my JotForm for this example, you'll see that I've created a very simple application form in the same style and theme as the previous one. That is, I'm collecting contact information, the name and the email. This is personal contact type of stuff. And then we also want to collect information about the application itself. How many employees do you have is a sample question I threw in here. And the all important, how do you feel about Star Trek? You either agree that it's clearly better than Star Wars, or you're not really sure what Star Trek is. And the way you answer this question is going to help me determine if you're a good fit for working with our company or not. So I can plug a question like this in and use it as a qualifier question in my application. So when somebody fills this out, how do we bring in that information and automatically put it in our Airtable database? Over here in our Airtable database, we see that we have a name and email field. So if I were a contact in my database, it would look like this. And then, of course, I could have multiple applications that I had filled out that would be linked here. So in my second table, I store my application information, and I would have a linked relationship to the contact. They would answer a number of employees. They would respond with their feelings about Star Trek. And of course, the date submitted, this particular field is capturing metadata that helps us understand when this application came in. Of course, this is only going to be created one time per application. So how do we build this inside of Make? Well, first things first, we need to get inside of our Make account. Your dashboard will look something similar to this. Make sure you've selected the right organization from the dropdown. And then we're going to go to build a scenario. Inside of this scenario, I'm going to create a scenario. And the first thing I need to do is bring in my first app, my first software. Now you can find JotForm just by typing J-O-T. And this will allow you to watch for new submissions on that form, or you can create a new form, get monthly user usage, get form submissions, or get user submissions. What I want is that trigger. This is going to be the thing that kicks off our automation. So I'll make this selection here. It's then going to ask me to choose a hook, and I will need to add one if I don't already have one. We need to first choose our JotForm account. In this case, I need to add that connection. In order to do this, I need to first grab my API key. If you're not sure how to do that, we'll first need to go back to JotForm, and we need to go to the account level here. Go back to our JotForm and go into the actual settings of the account itself. I can do that by selecting in the upper right corner. And once we're here, once this loads up, we're gonna see some options for API. On the left-hand side, simply choose API. If you need to create a new key, you can, or you can use a pre-existing key if you already have one created. Once you've created it, go ahead and grab that information, that API key, and you'll have to make sure that you have the right level of permissions for that particular key, if you want read access or full access in this case. I'll flip now back into Make, and I will paste that API key back here, and I'm going to save it up. Once Make has taken a moment, it's going to then be connected to our JotForm. And now we can select the form from within all of our different forms that we've built in JotForm. Now I use JotForm extensively, so I have quite a few forms down here, but it's right there at the top, the most recently created form. In this case, it's called Fake Application. So I'm going to go ahead and save that up. And what this means is as soon as a new form is submitted from JotForm, it is going to collect that information and trigger our automation. Before we flip back into JotForm, first we want to say that we are ready to run this particular trigger. We're going to say run and we see that it's searching, but of course we haven't submitted anything yet. We can flip now back to JotForm and publish this form, go to the actual live link for our form and fill it out with some fake information. We'll go ahead and put some sample data in here, make some selections, and submit that form. As soon as we do, we flip back into our Make account, and we see that we get this green checkbox that's saying, hey, I was able to identify that somebody in fact did submit that form. And if we click on this bubble here to look and see what it is, we see all the information that was just submitted. These are the answers that I was just providing on that form. I filled out the fake application form. I submitted my name, my email address. I answered how many employees I have, etc. So all of that information was properly captured by JotForm. Now what I want to do is look to see if I can find this contact already existing in my Airtable database. Remember, the whole point of this is if the contact already exists, which it does here, we see that we already have this email address inside of our table, well, then I don't want to create a new one. But if it doesn't already exist, then I want to create it. In either case, I then want to record the application in my second table and properly link that application back to that contact. So let's do that. The first step is to search for the contact. So we're going to add another module here. In this case, we're using Airtable, so I will search for Airtable. Here it is. And I want to search for a record. I'll make that selection here. If you already have your Airtable account connected, you can just select it here, or we'll need to add it manually, just as we did with JotForm. I head on into Airtable. I go into my account in the upper corner. I select that. It'll open up in a new window, and we'll be able to pull our Airtable API key. Go ahead and copy that, flip back into Make, and paste our API token. I can then save this up, and I'll now have a proper connection to Airtable. And now I need to map it to my base. The name of this database is Applications, so let's go ahead and make that selection. I can find it just like that by starting to type out the word. And how am I going to determine what record I'm bringing back? Well, I want to look in my contacts table. So what we need to do here is go ahead and enter in a formula where we get a true value. We want to find a record that may already live in our Airtable base with a unique ID. And the best way to do that in the terms of contacts is to use email addresses because they are always unique. So I will use the email address that was provided for us in the form submission. I can select here in the formula and I find all of the different elements from our form. Well, in this case, the email is right here, so I can make that selection. Now, one thing to note is that we need to make sure that we're writing a valid Airtable formula. This email is going to be read as text, so we have to make sure to include it with some quotation marks around it. Either single or double quotes are going to help Airtable understand that we are working with text here. So we are saying, whatever text you found in the email field that was submitted in the form, I want you to compare that to, and I want you to return a true value when it's equal to the email field in Airtable. Now we have to match our field name identically, so we'll flip back into Airtable, and our field name is email. This is case sensitive, so go ahead and copy and paste whatever the name of that field is. I'm going to go back into Make now, and because this is an Airtable field, I have to make sure to use squiggly brackets around it. So inside of those squiggly brackets, I will paste in the name of my field in Airtable. And then I will drop down to the bottom question where it's asking me how many records I want to return. And if I already have multiple contacts with the same email address, I already have a duplicate entry. So I only want to return one, so I can limit it to one record being found per iteration. And I'll go ahead and say okay here. And now I want to test this particular module out. I'll do that by right-clicking here and say run this module only. Remember, when I run this in a normal operation, it will be sequential. So first the trigger, but when I run the module by itself, it doesn't know what email I'm looking for. So I have to key that in here, which is actually a nice feature. It allows us to test step by step. So I'm going to look for this email address and click OK. And if it's able to find it in my Airtable database, because the record already exists, we're going to get that green checkbox and we can look at this magnifying glass and it's telling us everything it found out about that record in Airtable. Now, sometimes it might not find it and that's okay. That's exactly why we're building this automation, because sometimes it will find it, sometimes it won't. So what happens if it does? That's one path. What happens if it doesn't? That's a different path. In order to build a path, I'll want to add a router to my automation. Down here in Tools, I can control the flow of my automation, and I'll bring in this router element and plop it in right here. Now, this router is going to allow me to have two different paths. If something happens in one direction, it'll take path one, or under other circumstances, it will take path two. We know that those circumstances are, were you able to find a record in Airtable? If you found one, great. If you didn't, we need to go down a different path. So let's go ahead and build that router appropriately. In the case where we do find something, I want to take my top path. And in the case where we didn't find a contact, I will take my bottom path. So I will go ahead and click a filter here. I will go ahead and set one up. And I will say the condition I'm looking for is that this record existed. So we can say this condition, this exists. If we never found a record, then this ID would not exist. If we did find a record, the ID obviously exists. Let's go ahead and create a label for this as well so that it's easier for us to identify this in the future. So I will simply say record exists and I'll say okay. Now I want to build the opposite of that for the other path here. So I'll click on this wrench and set up this filter. I'll say this is record does not exist. My condition here again will be that this ID does not exist, and click OK. So now only one of these two things can be possible, and I can start building out these different paths. Now for the sake of brevity, let's build out one of these paths where the record does in fact exist. I will add the next step of the module here. What do I want to do? Well, I don't need to create a new contact for this particular path. Instead, I will just create the application record. So I will choose to create a record. I have to set it up to my Airtable connection. Again, choose my base, which is called Applications. Make that selection here. And I have to tell it what table I want to create this record in. In this case, it's my application table. Let's go ahead and make that selection. And how do I know what the number of employees is? Well, that information came in my form. So let's go ahead and find that answer. The question was, how many employees do you have? I simply make that selection here. What are your feelings about Star Trek? That's my next question. So I can select inside of this space and I can go ahead and plop in the answer that came again from the form. Now, where things get a little tricky is if we are connecting records, and in this case, we are. The application connects to a contact. So how do we get this? We add the item for this record ID, and it is the ID that we found in the previous module. Make that selection here. Now, we can choose to turn on mapping here, which makes things a little bit easier. And one other thing to note is the smart links. You'll see that it tells us with a little light bulb here, if Smart Links is enabled, you can use names for linked records. This is often very helpful if you don't already have the record ID. And you can also select an existing record or create a new one if it doesn't exist. This also pertains to single and multiple select fields. In our particular case, we are using single select fields. Flipping back into our database here, in my application table, these are single select fields and I don't yet have answers for these dropdowns, so I better enable smart links in my make automation. I'm gonna make sure that that is turned on. That way I can create new options in my single select dropdown and I will say okay. Now, when you're ready to test the scenario with some live data, you'll have to make sure to turn it on. Of course, we've only completed one of our paths. If we were to make this full automation, we would want to, in our second path, first create the contact because it would not have been found in the second step. And then we would want to create the application record and link it to the contacts that we had created here. But for the sake of brevity, we will go ahead and skip that section. We've turned our automation on. Make sure to save the scenario and go back out to your dashboard. Don't stay inside of here. Otherwise, sometimes the automations don't trigger. We now see that we have an active scenario that we can test. And I will go ahead and open up the information in JotForm, open the form again, I'll fill it out. I have to make sure to use an email address that already exists in my database, select how many employees we have, and answer the question appropriately and submit. Once we do that, we can flip back into Airtable just in time to see that that information was just added. Again, because we turned on that smart links, we were able to create the option of employees and create the option of how we should feel about Star Trek. So now that application is received and properly linked to the contact, I'll leave it to you to figure out the second half of the scenario where you would have to first create the contact if it doesn't already exist. But this is an overview of how you can use Make to superpower your Airtable database with third-party apps that you're using in other areas of your business. I hope you got a ton of value out of this video. Please leave any comments you have below and make sure you're subscribed to this channel if you want to stay on top of no-code and no-code information. That's it for now, and I will see you in the next one.
As always, I hope you found that to be extremely helpful. If you did and you'd like to learn more, swing by our website and see how we can help. We offer a free Airtable crash course that will help you level up in Airtable quickly, and we also have some paid services, including hourly consultations with our experts. We have some online courses and a group coaching program, and for advanced needs, we can build a bespoke solution for you from scratch. So swing on by, and I look forward to connecting with you soon.